Beautiful. Welcome back to Streamer. So here's another vlog, a moral story in English, and there's a beautiful butterfly roaming around and I'm busy looking at it, I mean staring at it. Okay, let's come back to the story. So the title of the story is just this. So once upon a time there lived a fisherman and a police officer. So as usual, the fisherman was selling his fresh fishes in the market. And then this policeman comes and that officer comes and picks up that fresh fish and starts walking away from the shop. Meanwhile, the fisherman says, "Hey officer, you did not pay for my fish. You should be paying for it. It's just this many rupees." And then the officer says, Did we ever pay to someone else? No, right? So why will I pay for you? Pay for the fish also." And the fisherman was all left wondering and was crying that what should I do now? That the police officer is very powerful and I'm not. I'm a poor person. So policeman was walking towards his home and the fish was fluttering. I mean, the fish was half alive, and on the way to the road, the fish bites the policeman's finger. Now, he thinks it to be a very usual scene, like if there's something that's half alive, it will just attack on you. So he thinks it's a normal thing. So he goes to home, he reaches his home, he gives the fish to his wife for cooking it, and he just washes his hand and bandages the cut and sits down to relax. After a few minutes, he sees that the finger is swelling up. He goes to a doctor who resides near his home. The doctor says, "We have to cut your finger, else your whole hand will be cut. So what has happened is that the poison has started spreading in your body. So we need to cut the finger right now. So you have to take the decision very fast, very quickly. Okay, we can't help you out afterwards." So the police officer thinks, "Yeah, it's better if I get my finger cut right now, else slowly and steadily my whole hand will get cut. So it's better I just stop the poison out there itself and cut it." He gets his finger cut. Now he has 4 fingers in one hand instead of 5. He goes back to his home. He sits down again. And slowly and steadily his palm starts to swell and the pain increases. He goes back to the doctor. He says, "You said that if I cut my finger, my hand will be saved. But now I see my palm swelling up. It's swelling up like a balloon. What should I do?" The doctor says, "We have to cut your palm. The poison is spreading very fast. And if you don't cut your palm right now, your hand will be cut. So take the decision very quickly. We can't wait for your decision for a longer period." "Okay." The police officer said, "Okay, cut my palm, no issues." Okay, now his palm is cut. He goes back to his home. Please remember, he did not have his fish yet. The fish is being cooked. Slowly and steadily, he sees that the pain is increasing and his hand starts to swell up like a balloon. The pain is increasing and his friend comes home. He sees and asks, "What happened to your hand? Why is it swelling up and where is your palm and fingers?" He said, he narrates the whole story to his friend. Now, his friend says, "Did you pay to the fisherman?" He said, "No, I did not. I just came away and then the fish bites me." And he narrates the whole story properly. His friend says, "Get up. We will go to the fisherman's house right now." The police officer says, "Okay." His friend says, "You have to say him a sorry. Okay, you have to tell him a sorry. You have to seek mercy." "Okay, done." The police officer and his friend reaches to the fisherman's home and the police officer says sorry from his heart. The fisherman was very kind and he said, okay, it's okay, I grant you a mercy. It's fine, it's okay. And then the police officer's friends asked the fisherman, did you give him a curse? Like after he went from your shop, did you say him something on his back? The fisherman says, I just asked my God to give me justice. Like he took away my fish without actually giving me the pay for the fish for my hard work that I caught the fish from the sea first and then I sold it. So I just asked my God to give me justice for the same. The moral of the story is you should never ever take someone else's right. You know, you should never take someone for granted. So with this, we come to an end to today's episode. We will meet you next Thursday with a new story. Till then, goodbye.